Nova Communication, Toastmasters Club.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I want to speak about my experience in Spain concerning four areas. The police, the beggars, the weather, and the way Spanish people park their cars. Because in this area, I really think that Spanish people are weird. So, I tell you, in Madrid, in particular Madrid, there is more policemen than normal people. There's simply not enough crime to entertain them all. And usually, in Denmark, when I try to be funny, I usually say, how many cops does it take to screw in a light bulb? Just one. But he's never around when you need him. And the funny thing is, when I try to be funny in Spain as well, I say the same joke. But usually people say, but there's one over there. There is one over there speaking in his phone. And that's quite weird. It reminds me of some time ago, in an intersection in Madrid, I saw two policemen. They were standing 20 meters apart, and they were talking in phone with each other. And the conversation sounded a little like this. Hello, John. Are there any crime at your corner? Hello, Rafael. No. I think there's simply too many of us. Do you want to grab a donut, and then afterwards we can pretend we're doing some investigation? And concerning the weather, I tell you, no one in Spain knows what rain is. Usually, when I asked strangers, is it going to be rainy today? They usually respond with, rain? What is that? And it's actually the totally opposite in Denmark. The weather is so bad. It rains all the time. It rains all the time. And we actually fill our pool with the rain we get. And then we wait for the sun to come so we can swim. But it never comes. So it's actually a shame. And another thing is that the reason we don't have so many police officers in Denmark is either because the robber hates the rain, or the police hates the rain. I actually think the robber would rather have a job indoor than sit out doing crimes or something like that. And the cops would rather be an indoor detective solving indoor crimes. So, in Spain, if seven kids and two dogs stand on an umbrella, how come they're not wet? Because it isn't raining. And, yeah. Concerning the beggars, tell you what, there's actually more beggars in Madrid and Denmark than in the beginning. I actually thought that, wow, we have such a good welfare system in Denmark, I'm so proud. But then I thought to myself again, no, they hate rain as well. They would rather sit indoor and have a job instead of begging, or go to Spain. You know, in general, beggars usually use their money for either cigarettes or alcohol. It's actually a little different in Denmark. Usually, the beggars first want a raincoat, then an umbrella, then a ticket to Spain, and then some cigarettes and alcohol. And I actually remember, it's quite funny, 3 months ago, when I took the plane, I actually saw a bunch of people in the back of the plane, in their raincoats, singing, we're going to Spain, no more rain. So, concerning the parking problems in Spain, there's really a lot. I have never in my life seen people park so close to each other. So they park so close to each other that if you want to give them a fine, cannot because the number will sit down. Again, no job for the police. Another thing is, I actually noticed when I came here, I actually thought that the cars was able to come out sideways, or else they simply could not get out. This is, then I saw this lady, a Spanish one, and I told her, shall I help you to get out? And she said, oh, tranquilo. And I have no idea what that means, but I don't think she really wanted my help. And then she backed her car, bang, smacked in the car behind her, and then she drove forward. And bang! She bumped into the car in front of her until she was out. I thought to myself, is that normal in Spain? So, in Denmark, we actually consider cars as an investment. But here in Spain, I think they probably consider it more as a toy or a bumping machine or something like that. I thought out that the reason Spanish people are late here in Spain is because they simply cannot get out of their cars. So my conclusion to all this concerning the police, the beggars, the weather, and the way people park their cars is, first, get a bicycle, or get a minivan. Never trust a man in a raincoat. Only wants your money, and if you want to get rid of him, get some rain. Finally, do some more crimes. The police will be grateful. Thank you very much.